Okay, so I'm trying to get some of this kitchen chaos under control, like unpack stuff before all the other stuff arrives. I've been following her for a while, but I went back and watched some of her old videos. Faith from Sparkly Blonde One, her husband made her like this wooden can riser. It looked really simple, so I'm gonna see if I can get Kevin to do that today so I can put away all these canned goods. Because there's some in there, I think there's some in that box there, and then I have a whole box coming with the stuff that's coming from Michigan in November. So that's one of my goals today, is to get these boxes. There's another one under there unpacked. This is gonna be our pantry. We got this from this guy. He was selling a bunch of cabinets, like just all together. So it's to take whatever we wanted for $100. So we have a couple out in the garage that are gonna go in the office, but this pantry was like a really good steal. It has a top and a bottom, and then the shelves are out in the garage. So I'm trying to get some of this chaos under control. It still has to be painted and stuff. There's Gabby. Okay, so that took a lot longer than it was supposed to because Kevin did all this fancy, smancy, unnecessary stuff, especially because he can't even see it. And I told him that. But I mean, it's done. I was able to get quite a few cans up on here, so grateful about that. I also will be storing cans in my pantry. So when all the other cans come, not my pantry, I have a closet or area of the house that I'm gonna designate, kind of like an overflow pantry. So I'll be putting all my canning stuff there and my canned goods and some other stuff. You'll see it when I get it all together. But yeah, we got this done, so why does it look like that? Okay, so I want to get the inside of this bottom part of this cabinet painted today. I don't know why it's not focusing. Yeah, I want to get the inside of this painted today because I have my NutriBullet that I want to put away and I need to find a container to put that in. So that's on the to-do list for today. I'm going to go ahead and clean this out and find the white paint so I can paint the inside of part of this. So got the first coat on. Just have to wait and I'll do a second coat and then I'll put down the, what is this called? Shelf liner. Look at all this. Yeah, there's a lot of work left to do in this kitchen. Awful. Okay, in the last video, I didn't show you guys the Christmas tree we ended up getting. We had to go to Lowe's and they hadn't stocked the tree that we originally the tree we originally wanted. It was out of stock a few weeks ago, like 2 or 3 weeks ago. It was out of stock in store and online because it's so pretty and it's so inexpensive. I think this was like 30 something, like 135, and it's a 7.5 foot tree. It's called the Fleetwood Pine Tree. Got this from Lowe's. So if you go to the Christmas trees and look for the boxes, look for the number 5. If you go to Lowe's and just look at the display, it's so pretty and it's so full, and it was just like a really good deal for what you get. It does feel kind of plasticky because it's a fake tree, but it looks really good, and it has little, can you see that? Little tiny pine cones in it. Pine cones. Where I get that country accent. It's little pine cones in it, and yeah, this is a tree we ended up getting, but I did end up getting also from Walmart. You saw in the last video this little ceramic ice skate ornament because Gabby starts ice skating this year, so I always try to get her an ornament that kind of like signifies whatever is going on that year. And so this year I thought like she would get an ice skate. I was gonna get the one from Dollar Tree and make it over to be pink, but this just is so much better and it was only $1 more. I don't really have to do anything to it except take all this, I don't know, take this stuff out. But I might paint it pink and then do the sole or the heel or whatever. Mosh Podge some silver glitter on it. But I don't know. Maybe I'll do pink and gold. I don't know. I do like the white. And it's got a nice weight to it for $1.98. So really excited about that. It is fine as it as is, but I have to DIY everything. And Gabby's tree is pink. I don't know, maybe a purple, a lavender. I don't know. Comment down below if you think I should give this a little bit of a makeover. It'll be with stuff I already have, so it won't cost me anything. But yeah, super excited about that. Because he's sick.
Yes, he is.
No. Well, what are you gonna color your other dogs?
So could just find red, I could make purple.
Well, I don't. We have to get all your crayons out of storage. They're still packed up.
Wait, let me just get a little stretch. Okay, I'm gonna go back together.
When I'm up through the night, I can't turn down the noise, tear all the worries out of my mind. About who I'm supposed to be, I start to believe I can't get it right. Remember the days I let slip away, they were simpler times. Mama told me before you leave, if there's only one thing you remember from me, child, when you're out on your own, a million miles from home, feeling the weight of the world on your shoulders. Child, don't forget who you are, don't lose your head or your heart. I'll bet my life on your stars, you'll be dancing, dancing on the moon. I bet my life, you'll be dancing on the moon.
Like this long, well, not long, but this explanation prepared for to like justify why I was painting the brick on my fireplace. I was gonna be like, oh, well, it's not original to the house and like all this stuff. And there's just like this whole community of people who like get upset when you paint over stuff, whether it be like wood or brick or whatever. And it's like if you post it online, you kind of have to, or you might get the feeling like you have to like kind of just like explain yourself. My explanation is, this is my house, I have to live here, and I want to enjoy this space. I want to be happy. I don't want to be sad when I come in here and see like this old yellow tone brick that like just isn't my style, and is it something that I like and enjoy? And I guess that's just the justification for it. Lately, all these interior design channels have been popping up. I don't know if they're like professional designers or whatever. And I've just been all these like video suggestions for like 10 things you should never do in your home and styles that are out for 2021. And you need to stop doing this. Do this. Like, bunch of people who have whatever opinions they have, which are justified for them, just telling people who have like people who like farmhouse, like, oh, you can't have farmhouse style. You don't live on a farm. You live in the suburbs, Deborah. Like, just, can everybody just do what they want and enjoy their home and be happy? On TikTok, there's like this whole like slew of people who shame women who, or women, not women, people who like Ray Dunn. I think Ray Dunn is cute. I personally don't own a lot of Ray Dunn. I probably own like just one Easter sign. It's just not my thing, but I wouldn't go out there and like go out and shame them and like categorize them and like, I don't know, just talk trash about them basically because they want to purchase a cup that says, I don't know, dog mom. I don't know what Ray Dunn mugs say. But it's just like, you can't exist on the internet without somebody being upset. So you might as well do what you want. And I want a white brick fireplace. The one thing about this house that I was really like wasn't too excited about was the bathrooms, but it's like, how much time do we spend in here anyways? So I did paint the floor black, but I do need to sweep. Look at that. One of the issues we ran into was that. That is the only outlet in this bathroom, and it's on this unfortunate looking light fixture. So we're gonna end up changing this out. We're gonna end up taking this medicine cabinet out too. But I found a system from IKEA that'll go behind the door. But yeah, back to the light switch. The solution that we came up with was to get this combination light switch outlet. And it'll make it so much easier because when I have to like straighten my hair and stuff, using that, like putting the cord all the way up there, I'm not that tall. This will work out so good because it's just at this level right here, and putting the cord up there to like straighten my hair and use my blow dryer and stuff isn't very optimal. Usually I'll just end up using that plug over there next to our bed, and it's not the best because there's no mirror in there right now. So I'm gonna see if I can get Kevin to pop this in so I can flat iron my hair. Yay! So got the new light switch in with the outlet so I can straighten my hair and do all the things I need to do in this bathroom. And yeah, so grateful to Kevin for getting that done. Okay, so finally got my nails painted. I know you were tired of looking at them because I was tired of trying to keep them out of frame. It's very early in the morning. Kevin just left for work. I'm still in my pajamas. Gabby's in bed. And I'm going to attempt to... I'm just going to town in my ear. I'm going to attempt to sew her Halloween costume. And I usually sew her Halloween costumes, but I sew them by hand because I'm a crazy person. And because of COVID, I didn't have to do one last year because we did not go trick-or-treating. But I'm going to attempt this year. Kevin got me a sewing machine for my birthday, and I've never sewn on a sewing machine before, so hopefully there isn't that steep of a learning curve for what I want to do for her costume this year. She wants to be a mermaid, so I have the fabric, I have the sewing machine still in the box, and we're going to attempt to get something passable, something that kind of looks like a mermaid. She might end up looking like a squid or some other kind of sea animal, but if as long as we land in the ocean, that's close enough for me. All right, so I'm gonna try to get this going. Kind of excited about this because learning to sew has been on my bucket list for about 7 years. So it's time to sew. So many years, too many tears on your pillow, on your pillow. Like actual body of the skirt done. I tried to do like a little rolled hem. Very sloppy, but it doesn't matter because I'm actually this is the waist, so I'm actually hand stitching some felt pieces right along here. But I just wanted to try it out, and it's far from perfect. But I'm okay with this for my first time. Gabby's still asleep, so I'm gonna wait till she wakes up to try this on to see if I need to take it in a little bit. But I'm super excited about all the projects I'm gonna be able to do on this.